Hello everyone. Today I am going to talk about propionic acid metabolism, propionic acid urea, and then methylmalonic acid urea. So we will talk first about propionic acid metabolism, that propionic acid pathway. Then we will talk about clinical condition, propionic acid urea and methylmalonic acid urea together. Let's begin with the topic. So pathway. In order to understand the pathway, we need to understand the context of the pathway, process of the pathway, and the substrate and enzymes that are involved in the pathway. So first, let's talk about context. So in context, why does this pathway happen? So if we want to understand context, we need to answer this question, why this pathway happens. This pathway occurs because the purpose of this propionic acid pathway is gluconeogenesis. So propionate will convert ultimately into glucose. Now, where does this pathway occur? So this pathway occurs in mitochondria of liver, especially liver. And then when does this happen? This happens during fasting condition and starvation condition. So this answer to these three questions will give the context. Where does this pathway occurs? When does this occur? Why does this pathway occur? Now let's talk about how this pathway occurs. So we will be talking about this in upcoming slides. What are the substrate and enzymes and coenzymes are involved in the pathway? So substrate that are involved in the pathway is propionic acid, that is breakdown product of amino acid, or chain fatty acid, phytonic acid, and byproduct of bile acid synthesis. And the coenzymes that are required here, the enzymes here required is propionyl coenzyme A carboxylase and methylmalonyl coenzyme A mutase. And propionyl coenzyme A requires vitamin biotin A here, and this methylmalonyl mutase enzyme require vitamin B12. So only these two enzymes will catalyze this process, and this is very important pathway. So let's see what are the sources of the propionic acid. So amino acids are the source of this propionic acid. First amino acid is valine, and second amino acid is isoleucine, third amino acid is methionine, and fourth is threonine. So we can remember this through mnemonics VIMT. So this four amino acid will produce propionate as a catalytic product. Now let's talk about lipid. In lipid, so O chain fatty acid, phytonic acid, and byproduct of bile synthesis. During bile synthesis, propionate is released. So these are the sources of propionic acid. So propionic acid is three carbon compound. You can see carbon one, this is two carbon, and third carbon. So propionic means three carbon containing carboxylic acid. After production of propionic acid from this pathway, so propionic acid is converted into methylmalonic acid. So carboxylation reaction occurs here. So addition of this carbon. Now second reaction is movement of this carboxyl group to this position. Mutation, that is isomerization. First reaction is carboxylation, and second reaction is isomerization. So this isomerization occurs like this, and methylmalonic acid is converted into this succinic acid. This way. Now let's talk about the pathway where we'll see these reactions. So first, this propionic acid is converted into propionyl coenzyme A. Now propionyl coenzyme A will be converted into malonyl coenzyme A through carboxylation, through addition of CO2 group. And this is ATP dependent process. Wherever biotin is there, the biotin always causes carboxylation, and this carboxylation is ATP dependent. So biotin does ATP dependent carboxylase. That is why this carboxylase, all carboxylase reaction enzymes, you can memorize them as A, B, C enzymes. So A for ATP, B for biotin, and C for carboxylase. So biotin does carboxylation through utilization of ATP. And the enzyme that does carboxylation is propionyl coenzyme A carboxylase. Now carboxylation occurs at this position, at second position like this. So this is methyl malonyl coenzyme A. So methyl malonyl is dicarboxylic branch chain fatty acid. So methyl malonyl coenzyme A is formed. Now methyl malonyl coenzyme A, when it is acted upon by vitamin B12 containing enzyme, vitamin B12 containing enzyme is methyl malonyl coenzyme A mutase. This is vitamin B12 containing enzyme. This vitamin B12 containing enzyme will isomerize this methyl malonyl coenzyme A, and it actually changes the position of this carboxy group from this second position to third position. And this is how it will, this succinyl coenzyme A is created. So there is requirement of two enzymes here, and there's two important substrate here. So first substrate is propionyl coenzyme A is converted into malonyl coenzyme A, and malonyl coenzyme is converted into succinyl coenzyme A. Here requirement is biotin, here requirement is vitamin B12. So let's see if there is deficiency in any of this, in this enzyme or this biotin, what will happen? So there will be increase in concentration of propionyl coenzyme. There will be increase in concentration of propionyl coenzyme. But what will happen if there is deficiency in vitamin B12 or this methyl malonyl coenzyme A mutase, or if deficiency is there in both? So what will happen is, so this reaction will not occur, and there will be high methyl malonyl coenzyme A. So this is very clinically very important concept. In the vitamin B12 deficiency or methyl malonyl coenzyme A mutase deficiency, there will be increase in methyl malonic acid, and in condition of propionyl coenzyme A or biotin deficiency, so there will be, if there is deficiency of this, so there will be increase in propionic acid. So this is very important concept to remember, and this pathway as such is very important. So remember this very important fact from this pathway. Now let's talk about the defect. So propionic aciduria, as I have told you, propionic aciduria is because of deficiency of propionyl coenzyme A carboxylase, and it can be because of deficiency of biotin also. And this methyl malonic aciduria is because of deficiency of methyl malonyl coenzyme A MMM, and or it is because of deficiency of vitamin B12. So either biotin or PCC can cause, or biotin plus this PCC, both, if even if there is a very less chance, there is no, both are rarely deficient, but if there is deficiency of both, there will be propionic aciduria. So both are related to propionic aciduria, and this vitamin B12 and MMM enzyme is related to methyl malonic aciduria. So these two are very important concept. This condition appear in newborn baby, or this condition can also occur in adult form. This condition also, this propionic aciduria and methyl malonic aciduria also is also presented as chronic form. So what are the presentation of this methyl? So this methyl malonic aciduria and propionic aciduria, clinically they are very difficult to separate. The presentation are very similar, and they both present with high anion gap acidosis, metabolic acidosis, and then there will be high urine ketone bodies, and there is hypoglycemia, because propionic acid is converted into succinyl coenzyme, and succinyl coenzyme will join citric acid cycle, and through citric acid cycle during fasting condition, so propionyl coenzyme will produce succinyl coenzyme, and this succinyl coenzyme through Krebs cycle in fasting condition it will produce glucose. Remember, purpose of Krebs cycle during fasting condition is gluconeogenesis, and purpose of Krebs cycle during fed condition is breakdown of acetyl coenzyme, so glucose synthesis. So that is why if there is defect in propionic acid pathway, what will happen? Hypoglycemia will happen, and then mild to moderate hyperammonemia will be there. So these are the four presentation that is seen in: first is acidosis, second is ketosis, and then hyperammonia. You can remember this presentation by this MAC. So M for metabolic acidosis, A for ammonemia, and K for ketone body. So this presentation, classical three presentation along with hypoglycemia is seen. All the clinical feature are because of this presentation in this individual. And then lab test. So generally lab test is done. Three lab tests are done. Lab test is done to assess organic acids present, and then amino acid and C3 carnitine. C3 carnitine, actually it is very important, because as soon as after child get birth, so this is part of newborn screening. So this test is done to screen child. Actually, newborn screen is done in all the patients, newborn patients, irrespective of disease presentation. This is done in all patients so as to find out disease. So this is, there is a panel of test in newborn screening, panel of test in newborn screening, and that test inborn error of metabolism. And so in that panel, this test is included. And now this test, if this is increased, this will signify propionic aciduria or malonic aciduria. After that, we can separate this disease based on different laboratory finding. So these are the laboratory tests that done to laboratory test done for organic acids, laboratory test done for amino acids, and then laboratory test done for C3 carnitine. So C3 is propionyl carnitine. Now let's see the laboratory presentation, detailed laboratory presentation in case of propionic aciduria. Actually, this case cannot be separated. These two condition cannot be separated based on clinical presentation. We have to separate them based on laboratory presentation. So let me first, before going to laboratory presentation, let me first tell a little bit about this high anion gap acidosis. What is high anion gap acidosis? What anion gap is? So just remember, anion gap means unmeasured anion. Here unmeasured anion is either propionic acid or methylmalonic acid. It can be propionic acid or methylmalonic acid. These are organic acids. So these are organic acid. You can call anion gap means organic acid. So high anion gap metabolic acidosis is means organic acidosis. This simple means organic acidosis. So this organic acidosis is classical presentation of this propionic aciduria and methylmalonic. This propionic acid is and methylmalonic acid, they are organic acids. Now let's differentiate this to amino acid metabolism. So this amino acid, this is propionic acid and methylmalonic aciduria can be separated based on laboratory findings. So laboratory finding, if we see in laboratory finding, so this propionic aciduria specifically have beta hydroxy propionic acid, high beta hydroxy propionic acid, very specific to propionic acid. But this methylmalonic aciduria will have high amount of methylmalonic acid. Methyl citrate is seen commonly in both disorder. Now we can see glycine is generally high in propionic acid, not necessarily, but glycine, if glycine is high, it will be propionic acid, it will be high in propionic acid. And then to see, we can see this C3-acyl-carnitine is common for both. So C3-acyl-carnitine and methyl citrate are common for both, and differentiating point is methylmalonic acid is present in methylmalonic acid urea, and it's propionic acid, beta hydroxypropionic acid is present in propionic acid. As the name suggests, propionic acid urea, so propionic acid will be there in propionic acid urea, and methylmalonic acid will be present in methylmalonic acid urea. And here we can see glycine can be present here. Now, so if this propionic acid, if it is because of enzyme deficiency, propionyl coenzyme A carboxylase, so these are the differences. If it is because of biotin deficiency, there will be addition of more acid will be there. Beta hydroxy isovaleric acid will be added to the list. If this methylmalonic acid urea is because of vitamin B12 deficiency, one more thing will be added to the list. Why? Because biotin is part of other enzyme also. Therefore, the deficiency in biotin will cause deficiency in other enzyme also. Therefore, this isovaleric acid is increased. Here, homocysteine will be high. So based on this laboratory finding, we can diagnose the condition whether it is propionic acid urea and methylmalonic acid urea. But they are little bit different in presentation also. So let's talk about presentation itself of this disorder. So presentation, so acute presentation in this disorder is, these are the present, the baby generally, baby present within 1 week. This baby will present under 1 week, and neonate will present with this presentation in acute condition within one week. And this both disorder as autosomal recessive disorder. Autosomal recessive disorder. Recessive disorder. Therefore, this such type of disorder, in order to have such type of disorder, both parents has to have this defective gene. What will happen? This presentation, there will be neonatal sepsis-like presentation. Neonatal sepsis-like presentation is because of metabolic acidosis that happens in this patient. So if metabolic acidosis happens, what will happen? There will be increased proton inside brain also. And that increased proton will activate respiratory center. Activate respiratory center and cardiovascular center. CVS center, CVC, respiratory center and cardiovascular center, that is present in bones and medulla, brainstem. And that will cause increased respiration, increased heart rate, increased respiration. And then there will be defective temperature regulation. So hypothermia can be seen in such baby. Nausea, vomiting, poor feeding, dehydration. These are the classical picture of and the metabolic acidosis. And this metabolic acidosis present like symptoms of sepsis. Sepsis-like picture is seen. So metabolic acidosis has sepsis-like picture in newborn. Now what will happen? So nervous system will also be involved because of this high organic acids and acidosis. So there will be encephalopathy. Encephalopathy means consciousness is altered. Consciousness, this affect encephalopathy is consciousness affect. So cerebral cortex is involved and consciousness is affected. And there will be seizure also. So seizure and encephalopathy are present in, are common in both the symptoms, propionic acid urea and methylmalonic. And there are very important presentation, neutropenia and pancytopenia. Important hematological findings is neutropenia and pancytopenia. And because of metabolic acidosis, there will, when proton is, remember this rule, when proton is high, K plus, this proton is high, potassium will also be high generally. So this high potassium concentration will cause effect on heart. So acute cardiac failure can happen in such condition because of high acidosis. So this presentation are because of high metabolic acidosis. I told you to remember high metabolic KAM, ketone bodies, ammonia and metabolic acidosis. So because of this finding, this ketone body rises, metabolic acidosis is there. That is why this all clinical presentations are seen, neurological presentation as well as this heart rate increase, temperature dysregulation, respiratory rate increase, heart rate increase, poor feeding, vomiting, dehydration. These are the features which is seen, and hematological features are neutropenia, pancytopenia, and neurological features are encephalopathy and seizures. These are common findings in both in propionic aciduria and methylmalonic aciduria. So what is the difference between the how do they are different in acute presentation? See, this severe movement disorder is very peculiar to propionic aciduria. And this propionic aciduria, neurological outcome is poor in propionic aciduria. Neurological outcome is poor in comparison to methylmalonic aciduria. In methylmalonic aciduria, it involves basal ganglia, and it also present with stroke-like episode. What does a stroke-like episode means? This is a sort of metabolic stroke. The stroke. There is two type of stroke. One is vaso-occlusive stress. Other is metabolic stress. Metabolic stress. So stroke. So this metabolic stroke, because of metabolism, and there will less supply of glucose to the body organ, brain, and that is why stroke like of presentation, hemiplegia like of presentation is seen. But it will recover after giving glucose, it will recover. That is why this is called stroke-like episode and metabolic stroke. This is a sort of metabolic stroke. This is metabolic stroke and basal ganglia lesion. So what is basal ganglia lesions? When there is lesion in basal ganglia, there will be ethmoid movement, chorea, hemibelismus. So this type of presentation are associated with methylmalonic aciduria, while propionic aciduria acute presentation will be severe movement disorder only. So movement of hands, jerky movements of hands will be there, but it is not similar to chorea. So these are the difference between acute presentation of propionic aciduria and methylmalonic aciduria. Now let's talk about chronic presentation. Some patient of this will have chronic presentation. If the baby has acute presentation, it will see within 1 week, but some baby will have chronic presentation. So episodic chronic presentation will be there. In episodic chronic presentation, the patient will have episodes of vomiting that is accompanied by this ketoacidosis, anorexia, and failure to thrive. The growth of baby will not be proper. So vomiting, episodes of vomiting and poor feeding, anorexia will be there, and then this baby will not grow nicely. And neurological presentation will be seen. Mental retardation, chronic, because of chronic, it is chronic, that is why mental retardation is seen. And then hypotonia, dystonia, and seizures type of presentation are seen. So loss of tone, abnormal tone, dystonia means abnormal tone of muscle, loss of tone of muscle, and seizures. This type of musculoskeletal manifestation, neuromuscular manifestation will be seen. Optic disc will be atrophy, can be atrophy in such conditions. So this presentation are in muscle, hypotonia, dystonia, and seizures, mental retardation, and there can be optic atrophy, means blindness can, because of this, there can be blindness. Chronic presentation can be associated with blindness, mental retardation, and hypotonia, dystonia, seizure. Now hematological features, presence of neutropenia and pancytopenia. So propionic aciduria has propionic aciduria. This is the difference between propionic chronic presentation of propionic aciduria and methionic. So propionic aciduria present with cardia, cardiomegaly. And this methylmalonic aciduria is present with chronic renal failure. These are the differences in chronic. So what was the difference in acute presentation? The difference in acute presentation was the movement disorder is associated with propionic aciduria, and this stroke like of metabolic stroke and basal ganglia lesion is present with methylmalonic aciduria. So these are the differences in presentation, and there is this disorder are diagnosis of this these two disorder is based on laboratory finding mainly. So thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe and put a like, press like button, and thank you for watching.